Welcome to Spencer James Cars and welcome to the video for this absolutely gorgeous, really nicely specced Audi Q7. It's a 2016 model, and as you can see here, it's like a black edition. So look, you've got all the black grille and badge. Obviously it's a quattro, four-wheel drive. You've got the lovely LED headlights, no silver or chrome bits on the trim, on the bodywork. Really look great in this spec. Front parking sensors, rear parking sensors, rear view camera as well. All premium tyres, Pirelli. These alloy wheels, 21-inch alloy wheels, look really very, very nice. Hopefully you can see that. Well, black cars show all the marks, don't they? But this, very clean, excellent condition, absolutely defies the mileage and age. If you put a private plate on this, yeah, it looks very nice. It looks a lot newer. Show you all the bits here. Yeah, on the windows there, no chrome, privacy glass on there, all the way around. No badges on there as well. Black. But yeah, really good condition. Tyres and alloys again down the side here. It's an S drive as well. It's very, very, very difficult for me to find Audis in this sort of spec. Black edition, S line. You know, it's got the proper 3-litre diesel engine as well. Let me show you inside. Okay, so as I said, front and rear parking sensors, full S line spec. Reverse camera as well. We've got all the door, all the window and wing mirror controls there. The mirrors do fold in. Electric seats here with lumbar adjust. You've got the S-Line leather and Alcantara seats with the sports seats with the S-Line badge embossed. S-Line stitch, leather stitch steering wheel. We've got also got the virtual dash, so it brings the sat nav on the dashboard there. USB connections, auto lights, cruise control. It's a sports auto, so you've got these paddle shifts in here. All the controls on the steering wheel for the media. It's got Bluetooth audio, Bluetooth phone. You've got USB connection under the armrests, which extend out. Four-wheel drive, hill descend. You've got heated seats. The different drive selects as well there, so you can put it in like off-road modes and so on. But yeah, very, very nice spec car. It's got four-zone climate control as well, and it's a proper seven-seater, not like some of them where you can barely get anyone in the back. But yeah, these seats slide forward. You can you can decide how much room you divide up between the second and third row. Also, you can slightly recline the seats as well, so you can put this bit back just to make it a more comfortable position. But yeah, there you go. I've put the third row seating up, but real nice comfy seats, proper seats there. And depending on how you have the second row, you can see there's tons of space in front of that. So you can slide the second row forward here, and then you can get a lot more room in the back in the third row, depending on what you're looking for. And then you've got the controls here. You can just press these buttons in the door, and it brings these down and extends the boot or puts the seats up, however you wish to configure the car. But yeah, a very nice car, very, very nice spec, in great condition, full service history. Any questions, please don't hesitate to get in contact, but thank you very much for your time.